Hello everyone. In this video, we study about the Fourier series. First, we define the definition of Fourier series. It is expressing given periodic function as an infinite sum of trigonometric series or trigonometric functions is called a Fourier series. Now, for example, if I consider a function, a periodic function f of x defined in the interval. Defined on the interval c to c plus 2l, then the Fourier series expansion of f of x, in the sense here this f of x is a periodic function. Fourier series expansion of f of x is given by, see, we have to note down this formula. It is f of x is equal to a naught by 2 plus summation n running from 1 to infinity an cos n pi x by l plus summation n running from 1 to infinity bn sin n pi x by l. So this is the required Fourier series, because we can observe here in this term, we have the infinite sum of a trigonometric functions sine, cos, as well as a constant term. Here this a0, an, and bn are the Fourier coefficients, which can be found by using the explicit formula, where this a0 is given by 1 upon l integral c to c plus 2l f of x into dx, comma. The formula for an is 1 upon l integral c to c plus 2l f of x into cos n pi x by l into dx. Same way, to find out the constant bn, we have 1 upon l integral c to c plus 2l f of x into sine n pi x by l into dx. So these are the explicit formulas to find out the constants a0, an, and bn. Suppose if we want to have some different intervals instead of c to c plus 2l, how to write down those formulas? For example, I will take some different cases. So let us have some different set of cases where the formulas for the Fourier series varies there. Here, the first case, I take it as minus pi to plus pi is an interval. And the second case I am required with is 0 to 2 pi. So let us have the third case as minus L to L. And the fourth case be 0 to 2L. But in the above formula, the interval is c to c plus 2L. I'll just compare that interval with the required interval here. So this is minus pi to pi. I am equating with c to c plus 2L. So what we get here? So in place of c, we have minus pi. And in place of c plus 2L, we have pi here. So I'll solve this equation for the variable L. L can be written as pi minus c divided by 2. Here c is minus pi. We get L is equal to pi minus of minus pi, it will become 2 pi. Pi minus of minus pi by 2. So by solving this, we get L is equal to pi. In the sense, if we want to get the interval minus pi to plus pi, in the general interval, we have to substitute C is equal to minus pi and L is equal to plus pi. So this is for the case of minus pi to pi. Now, suppose if we want to have an interval 0 to 2 pi, I will compare this interval 0 to 2 pi with the general interval c to c plus 2n. Here in this case, we have c is equal to 0, and in place of c plus 2l, we have 2 times pi. I will solve the second equation for the variable l. It is 2 pi minus c divided by 2. Since this value of c is equal to 0, I get l is equal to 2 times pi by 2. That is, the value of l will be equal to pi. Means, if we want to have an interval 0 to 2 pi, we have to substitute c is equal to 0 and l is equal to pi in the general interval c to c plus 2l. So this is about the second case. Suppose if we have the interval minus l to l, what I do here, I'll compare minus l to l interval with c to c plus 2l. So in place of c, we have minus l, and in place of c plus 2l, we have plus l here. Okay. Now I solve this equation for the l now. So it is l will be equal to l minus of c divided by 2. So the value of c is minus l. L will be equal to l minus of minus l by 2. L plus l by 2. So the l value should be retained as l only. So if we want to have an interval minus l to l, where l is an arbitrary constant, we have to just substitute c is equal to minus l, and the l value should be retained as it is in the interval. Now, coming to the last case, if we want to have an interval 0 to 2l, I will compare the interval 0 to 2l with the general interval c to c plus 2l. In place of c, we have 0, and in place of c plus 2l, we have 2 times l. So now, put this c is equal to 0 in this, 2l will be equal to 2l I get. So 2l will be equal to 2l. In the sense, l should be equal to l itself. You have to retain the value of l. It means that if we want to have the interval 0 to 2l, we have to substitute c is equal to 0 as well as l should be retained as it is in order to get the interval 0 to 2l. So these are the different cases for the interval. Now let us see what will be the Fourier coefficient formulas for all these different cases. I'll just separate this cases. This is 0 to 2 pi case. And the next case is minus L to L. And the last case would be 0 to 2L. Thank you all.